Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about question answer writing of 64th BPSC exam. So in this session I would like to interpret some important question, how to write answer about that question. So first I take an important question, discuss the meaning and scope of applied anthropology. This question asked by BPSC in 64th exam. So how can you write about the answer of this question? So when you are going to write about the answer of any question, at first you have to write about introduction. So this is very simple question. So when you are going to write about the introduction of that question, you have to write what is applied anthropology, right? Means at first you have to write about what do you mean by applied anthropology. So simply you can write your answer, applied anthropology is the branch of anthropology which deals with the application of knowledge and data of anthropology for the solution of various practical problems of contemporary society. This is applied anthropology, right? After that, you have to write about answer of a scope of applied anthropology. So when you are going to write about the answer of a scope of applied anthropology, it is a main part of this question. So, the scope of applied anthropology is very wider because it can be further divided into three major sub-branches: applied physical anthropology, second, applied cultural anthropology, and third, applied archaeology, right? And here applied physical anthropology again further divided into many sub branches. Forensic anthropology, second, nutritional anthropology, third, anthropology of sports. Anthropology of sports. Next, medical anthropology. Next, epidemiological anthropology. And next, eugenics, right? So when we are going to write about the applied physical anthropology, you have to explain about these sub branches of physical anthropology. So basically in forensic anthropology, we utilize knowledge and data of physical anthropology or biological anthropology in law and justice for identification of criminals and victims or personal identification. Second, nutritional anthropology, In this branch of anthropology, we analyze about knowledge and data of biological and cultural anthropology for the solution of nutritional problem of our contemporary society. And in anthropology of sports, we utilize knowledge and data of biological anthropology for the betterment of sports. Data gathered by biological anthropologist is utilized for selection of sports person, their training, management, and socialization of sports in society. Next, knowledge of medical anthropology is utilized for the preservation of knowledge of ethnomedicine of primitive people. It is very useful for the development of ethnomedicine for our contemporary society. Next, epidemiological anthropology. The knowledge of epidemiological anthropology is very useful for the solution of epidemic problem, epidemiological disease. That is very useful for the solution of these types of diseases which are spread in our society due to biocultural environmental factor. So, knowledge gathered by epidemiological anthropology is useful for the solution of these types of problem. Eugenics, this is an important branch of human genetics which give focus to promotion of that people who are genetically fit. So eugenics give us concept those person are genetically healthy, they have to reproduce child, and those are not genetically healthy, they have not to reproduce child. If we follow that, then frequency of healthy gene can be increased in our society, and then we can solve about some various genetical problem in our society. Knowledge and data of applied physical anthropology is also useful for diagnosis, prevention, and treatment of human genetic disease, and it is also useful in genetic counseling. Second important part, applied cultural anthropology. It is a very important branch of applied anthropology, and knowledge gathered by sociocultural anthropologists is utilized for making policy program for tribal and rural development, their implementation and evaluation. Second, it is also useful for the solution of tribal displacement and rehabilitation problem. It is also useful for implementation of sustainable development program in society. It is also useful for the solution of ecological imbalance and environmental pollution like problem. Knowledge and data gathered by sociocultural anthropologist is useful for the reducing social tension in multicultural society, because sociocultural anthropologist study society and culture according to concept of cultural relativism, which is very useful for the solution of sociocultural tension in multicultural society. We can utilize knowledge and data of cultural anthropology for the solution of various types of ethnic problem in multi-ethnic society. It is also useful for the solution of extremist like problem, terrorist. It is also useful for the solution of poverty, solution of the problem against women, crime against women. It is useful for the personality development. It is useful for solution of various types of social problem. And basically, knowledge and data gathered by sociocultural anthropologist does very important role for the solution of various practical problem. Anthropologists work as a representative of primitive society or primitive people, because they have knowledge and data regarding primitive culture. They also does important work as a facilitator in format consultant analyst and mediator for tribal and rural development, and sometimes they use their knowledge and data directly in action anthropology. This is the new branch of anthropology. So this data is very useful for the solution of various socio-cultural problems of our society. Another important aspect of applied anthropology is applied archaeology. Here, knowledge of archaeological anthropology is utilized for preservation of past and cultural resource management, cultural resource management, and knowledge of linguistic anthropology is also utilized for development of easy communication and development of dual language education program, and for the research in tribal society. In this respect, on the basis of that discussion, we can see that the scope of applied anthropology is very wider, because knowledge and data gathered by anthropologists is very, very relevant for our contemporary society. So it is relevant for our contemporary society. So on this regard, you can write answer. And today I am going to discuss with you about an important question of a BPSC 65 exam. And that question is, explain meaning and a scope of economic anthropology with a special reference to formalist and substantive school of thought. So basically, this is very important question asked by BPSC. And when we try to analyze about the nature of that question, this question is a complex for BPSC student. So today I will try to explain how to write answer about that question. So before we are going to write about the answer of that question, you have understood it has three important major components. First important component is meaning and scope of economic anthropology. Second important concept, formalist school of thought, and third important concept is substantive school of thought. So it has three important components. So try to understand one by one these component. So first important thing is that when you try to write about introduction about the meaning and a scope of economic anthropology, so it has two important things. One is, what is the meaning of economic anthropology? So simply, you can see economic anthropology is a branch of sociocultural anthropology which deals with the study of economic organization, economic activity of primitive people cross-culturally. Secondly, when you try to write about the scope of economic anthropology, so that the scope of economic anthropology gradually expanded, right? Because when you write about the introduction, economic anthropology is a branch of sociocultural anthropology which deals with the study of economic activity of mankind cross-culturally.
So you understand three important steps or stage. First stage is development of traditional economic anthropology. So in traditional economic anthropology, basically that was developed in 19th century, we mainly focus to a study about primitive economy. And when we are going to study about primitive economy, we try to understand primitive economy in socio-cultural perspective. So integration of economic life with the social and cultural life is very important thing when we try to understand about the meaning of economic anthropology and the scope of economic anthropology. That was traditional economic anthropology that was developed in 19th century. So in this period, the scope of economic anthropology was very limited, because basically economic anthropologists mainly interested to study about natural environment of primitive people. Secondly, they also give focus about nature influenced about the economic activity of primitive people. Secondly, they also study about the technology, because the technological development is integrated with their natural environment. Third, they also study about their social organization, because in primitive economy there was no any concept of labor organization, and supply of labor done by kinship or their social organization. So economic activity is not only economic activity, that is social process in primitive people. And basically their economy is subsistence economy. So that whole economic system based on concept of reciprocity, and they also believe that whole economic production influenced by their supernatural, because that depend on the bliss of supernatural. So when anthropologists try to understand about their economic life, their economic organization, their economic activity, they follow these types of, these kinds of approach. And through socio-cultural perspective, we try to understand about economic organization, economic activity, economic life of the people of primitive society. So that was basically developed in 19th century. So at first, if I write about that thing, that important concept, that important facts, after that in 20th century, in early 20th century, there was a development of new thought, new views, new method in economic anthropology, and in which first important thing is development of formalist view in economic anthropology. So second important component of that question about a formalist school of thought or formalist view regarding economic anthropology. So before you are going to write answer, at first you try to understand about what is that formalist view, how that view developed, and what was the impact of that view on the study of economic anthropology, their meaning and their scope. So two important personality you have remembered. First is Raymond Firth, and second is M.G. Herskovich. So Raymond Firth, in his famous work Primitive Polynesian Economy, 1927, he founded the view, the theory of formalist economic anthropology, and he enhanced that view in his famous work Primitive Economy of New Zealand Maoris in 1929. In 1940, M.G. Herskovich In his famous work, The Economic Life of the People of Primitive, The Economic Life of Primitive People in 1914, M.G. Herskovitz also supported the view of Raymond Firth and Formalist School of Thought. So basically, Formalist School of Thought was based on some important concept. And first important thing is that they said that theories of formal economics or classical economics are useful for the understanding of both primitive as well as modern economic system. So they said that theory of demand and supply, theory of scarcity of resources and selection of needs, theory of maximization of profit, role of market are very important. These are very important concept or theory for the understanding of primitive economy as well as modern economy, because if we apply these types of theory for the understanding of primitive economic system, we can better understand about primitive economy. And they also said that statistical and mathematical method and quantitative data are also useful for the understanding of primitive economy. So that was the basic thought of a formalist economic anthropologist. An important case study you can mention, and that was very important for the answer writing of this question. Soltex was American anthropologist, and he had done a study in Guatemalan Indian society for testing hypothesis of formalist school of thought in 1953. So in 1953, Soltex, in his famous work, Penny Capitalist, A Guatemalan Indian Economy, said that Guatemalan society is a primitive society and their economy is at the stage of primitive. But they are using these concepts which proposed by formalists, like theory of demand and supply, theory of scarcity of resources, maximization of profit, role of market, mathematical statistical method and quantitative data. So on the basis of that case study, Soltex said that this concept is useful for the understanding of primitive economic system. So that is new thing in economic anthropology, and due to introduction and due to application of formalist view, the meaning and scope of economic anthropology, the meaning and scope of economic anthropology, both are changed. And due to the impact of formalist in economic anthropology, we started a study both modern and primitive economic system, and by the application of these theories. But in 1957, Carl Polanyi, in his famous work Trade and Market in Early Empire, criticized about formalist view of economic anthropology. Carl Polanyi said that theory of formalist economy and theory of classical economy are not useful for the understanding of primitive economy, because primitive people producing something for fulfillment of the need of their society, not for the need of market, which is regulated through theory of demand and supply. So primitive people fulfill their social need through economic production, not fulfill the need of market. So there is no scope of application of theory of demand and supply for the understanding of primitive economy. Second, he said that there are no scarcity of resources in primitive society because their needs are limited. So they easily fulfill their needs without selection between their resources and need. Third, he said that primitive people doing their economic activity for the fulfillment of the need of their society, and they are not influenced by the theory of maximization of profit because they are doing economic activity for the fulfillment of basic need of their community. So they are not influenced by the theory of maximization of profit. And then he said that the role of market is quite different in primitive society, because in primitive society, market is social place where primitive people not only fulfill their economic need, but also fulfill their social, their cultural, their political needs. So the role of market is quite different in primitive society than modern society. And then he said that because anthropologists study society economy through fieldwork method, through participant observation, by which they gathered qualitative as well as quantitative data. So there is limited scope of application of mathematical statistical method for the understanding of primitive economy. So through that, Karl Polanyi rejected the view of formalist economic anthropologist. And Karl Polanyi said that if we try to understand about primitive economy, we have to understand primitive economy in socio-cultural perspective, which based on cross-cultural study. And therefore, he said that we have to study social and cultural perspective of the people of primitive society for the understanding of their economic activity, economic organization, or economic life. Because their economic life is the part of their socio-cultural life, and that is fully integrated with their society, fully integrated with their culture, and that regulated through cultural rule, social rule, not regulated through economic rule like demand and supply, right? So he rejected, and he again gave focus to a study of economic anthropology in sociocultural anthropology, and he also gave focus to a study of primitive society as a core subject matter of economic anthropology, right? So this is substantive school of thought. That thought supported by many famous anthropologists like Branislav Malinowski. But here, you have to write what happened after development of these types of school. So basic thing is that due to development of these types of thought, meaning and scope of economic anthropology are changed. Now, economic anthropology is a branch of sociocultural anthropology which deals with comparative study of modern as well as primitive society, but mainly focused to a study of primitive society in cross-cultural perspective. But there are development of new component, new element in economic anthropology. Because nowadays, in economic anthropology, we not only study primitive economy, we also study rural economy, we also study industrial economy, corporate economy, we also study about economic life of people of urban society in urban anthropology. So due to that thing, the scope of economic anthropology became very broad, and now it is not only theoretical science but also applied science. So knowledge and data gathered by economic anthropology are useful for the welfare of mankind, and therefore now economic anthropology become very broad, very expanded. So through that you can write your answer.
So now we are going to write answer about an important question of BPC. That question is, explain the different form and function of family human society. Means in this question we have to write about different form of family, and second function of family. So basically this question has two broad aspect. First is explain the different forms of family, and second is explain the function of family. So when we are going to write about the answer of this question, first aspect of this question you have to write about family. Family is basic structural unit of human society, or family is a domestic group, and then you have to write about the various forms of family. So when we are going to study about forms of family, so forms of family is on the basis of a structure. First thing, on the basis of a structure. Second thing, on the basis of marriage. Third thing, on the basis of blood. Fourth, on the basis of residence. Residence, and next on the basis of succession. So basically for the writing of the answer of different form of family, you have to write form of family on the basis of five important criteria. And in first you have to write three important forms of family, that is nuclear family, second joint family, and third extended family. Second, on the basis of marriage, you have to write three important form of family. First is monogamous family. Second is polygynous family. And third is polyandrous family. On the basis of blood, we have only one form of family,
of Nair Society of Kerala on the basis of residence we have Patti local family, second Matti local family, third Bai local family, fourth New local family, and fifth Abhanku local family. And on the basis of succession, first Patti RK and Patti lineal and second Matti lineal.
So basically these are the important form of family. So when you are going to write answer on that, you only explain that in one or two line and make diagram, right, in such way and give important examples. Then you have also write about joint family. What is joint family? Make diagram and give example. In extended family you have also write what is extended family, make diagram and give example. In monogamous family you have to write what is this and make diagram and give example. You have to write polygamous family, what is this, make example and give diagram, present that in diagram. In polyandrous family you have to write what is polyandrous family, then make diagram and give example on the basis of blood. Only one family form, that is family Nair, and make diagram. On the basis of resistance there are five important family, and in that you have to write what is Patti local family, what is Matti local family, what is New local family, Bai local family and Abhanku local family, and also give examples regarding that. So when you have to present this thing, then you have to write on different form of family. Second important part of that, because it is a very broad question, so always remember that you have to write the name, then give example and make diagram. Second aspect of this question is function of family. So for writing of the answer of function of family, at first you have to define family is fundamental social institution of mankind, and after that you have to write about the function of family. So when you are going to write about the function of family, you have start writing about the function of family through an important case study which is done by G.P. Murdoch in 1949 in 250 societies, right? Basically he has done cross-cultural study
in 250 society, and on the basis of that, he said that family is a universal social institution which do important function, and that function is a regulation of sex between husband and wife. Second, reproduction. Third, economic production. And fourth, socialization of children. Socialization of children. So these are the important function of family which prescribed by G.P. Murdoch on the basis of that case study. Again, you can write about Talcott persons. Talcott persons also said that socialization is an important function of family. After that, you have to write about the function of family on their social function economic function, political, cultural, psychological, right? Because family work as a primary institution for primary education, of children. We learn importance of social relationship through family, and family does important function, economic function, for economic production and consumption because family does division of labor in their member, and by the help of their member family does economic production, and then family distribute goods and service to their member for the fulfillment of their consumption need. Next, political. Family does important role for social control in society. Social control in society. Here family does dispute settlement among their member. And in cultural, family does important role for the protection of religion, custom, tradition, morals, value, and psychology. Family makes psychological, sentimental relationship among their member, and family provide psychological security to their member, and therefore family does important function in human society. After that, you have to write your conclusion. On the basis of that discussion, we can see that family is universal social institution and social association of human society, and therefore family does important function in human society.